Hello, today I want to introduce some graphical user interface to the library which operate with Moebius invariant geometry. And this is a kind of interactive geometry package. You may be already familiar with some other existing interactive geometry packages, say CaRmetal is very good and excellent, KIJ, and of course GeoGebra. They are all mature, exist for many years, actually decades, and developed to rather interesting program products. Question is, do we need another interactive geometry package then? And my answer would be yes, if it will be different. And package which I am going to introduce is indeed different. As you can see, for existing packages there are quite a lot of similarity. They all have this kind of geometrical icons which represent different geometrical construction, and typical procedure look like that. You may click on the screen and create some points. Then for chosen points, you choose kind of construction which you want to make, say build a line through two points, and then you may introduce another point and drop a perpendicular from this line, from this point to this line, and so this is the perpendicular. And all other packages work in a rather similar manner. Package which I am introducing, this is a different one because it does not have amount of these geometrical icons. Instead, all construction are produced by these couple of buttons. We have a button define the cycle, which actually simply allow us to give a cycle, say with coordinates of center 0, 0, a radius 1. When this cycle is simply appears here on the screen, and we may add points here to the graph just clicking on corresponding locations. So this is how we introduce new objects, and then all other objects are produced by create button, create cycle button. And if we will attempt to create a cycle without any supplied information, of course answer will be undefined. So this is a cycle G which created here, it does not have parameters. So how to use this software properly? So let's start us from the scratch. So let's define two points. So we click on the screen. By the way, besides of tooltips which explain meaning of all elements, we may press as well Shift F1 to get a help prompt which tell us what is possible here. So when we have these two new points, let us define something which is called relation. We want to build a new cycle which has a relation to already existing one, and menu for relation is generated by right click on corresponding object, and here we choose the first relation orthogonality to A, and we choose relation orthogonality to B. When we select orthogonality to the real line as well as infinity are member of any figure, because for Moebius transformation they play special role, they always are presenting on the figure. So we have now the list of these relations. So here we select, we're trying to construct new cycle C, which has only real coefficient, and it will be orthogonal to A, orthogonal to B, and orthogonal to R. So let's try what we will see. what happened? We obtain the Lobachevsky line in the upper half plane, that is a circle which is orthogonal to the real line. Orthogonality to point A and orthogonality to point B means what our circle is passing with two points. Let's construct something different. We still choose orthogonality to A, we choose orthogonality to B, and this time we choose orthogonality to the infinity. So circle which passes the infinity, you can imagine it will be a straight line. Indeed, if we build with a circle, we see the straight line. Now we have a circle and real line. How to construct the intersection point? We still choose orthogonality to new cycle C, orthogonality to the real line, and we choose a relation of newly created cycle to itself. So to this cycle C, we choose relation orthogonality to itself. So it's appear here, new cycle will have a label E, and it will be orthogonal to itself. So let us see what we will obtain. We get the two intersection points. So here the solution which we constructed has two values, as we can see, two lines. Now we may add, so far everything which is on our figure was constructed using only relation of orthogonality. Let's slightly modify our construction. We take something orthogonal to line D, orthogonal to real line, and orthogonal to itself. So that will be the intersection point of these two lines, as we can expect from our previous experience. But besides of that intersection point which we can see on the screen, there is of course other intersecting point which is infinity. Both straight lines pass the infinity, and we may add a relation to infinity to be different. Or rather, we will choose almost different. So that is kind of relation which we may choose for any cycle to be either different or almost different. Almost different is helpful because our evaluation are done with float point rounding. So if we will choose exact evaluation for figure, then it will be more accurate without any rounding. But formulas became rather complicated, especially if we will choose relation like tangency on our screen, and even computer software may be not very happy with calculation. So this is the list of relation which we have choose so far, and we create a cycle. So new point F appeared, and because we exclude the second solution infinity, only one point here presented, unlike in the case of E where two points are presented. So this is what we obtained. Just again to make our picture a bit more exciting, let us try another relation. We take circle C and choose tangency, and we take this straight line and choose relation of tangency, and finally a tangency to the real line. Because there are a lot of possibilities here, we get a multiple solution. So actually there are eight different circles which are simultaneously tangent to these three different cycles. We may make our picture a bit more colorful. So for this cycle, say take the blue colors, and it's possible to choose either solid dashed or dot lines for them. Also the white of these lines can be modified. So this is, we get bluish cycles G which are tangent. So this is a new interactive geometry package. It operates differently from existing one, and you may be wondering what other differences are. Other differences came from possibility to choose different geometry. So here, geometry which we are choosing has elliptic signature, so it's -1, -1 in terms of metric. If we choose hyperbolic one with signature -1 and 1, then just the same picture will be transferred to collection of hyperbolas with the given properties. So hyperbolas are tangent to the real line, to the hyperbola C, which is passing point A and B, and so. Or we may choose the geometry which is parabolic, and when calculation produce the collection of parabolas with the same property. So actually this is again a different feature of this package, what it operates with three types of geometry, not only with Euclidean geometry as other packages, but also with hyperbolic metric and parabolic metric. Here hyperbolic metric is not in this sense which it's used in Lobachevsky geometry, because the signature of Lobachevsky metric is still -1, -1, and when we are swapping to hyperbolic, true hyperbolic geometry, signature became -1, 1, and object are corresponding hyperbolas. So this is a brief introduction of the main feature for the new package.